and good evening. Wonderful, wonderful chat. Okay. Okay, I can do this. I can do this. I'll play a scary game tonight. Ooh. Okay. Okay, chat. I normally don't play scary games. The reason for that is pretty easy. I get scared really, really easy. I'm one of those person who tries to hide her face when she's watching a spooky movie and stuff like that. I get really, really, really scared. But this is Saturday, and normally the spooky show of Vlad of the Weekendslice would be on. And so I thought, and this would be a good thing to also do something spooky tonight, because people need their spooky thing on Saturday night. So I have installed this game. I have put it in OBS, and I've not played it. I normally try to play the games I will stream. But in this case, I was just afraid that I would get so scared that I would then refuse to stream the game. So we can do this. We can do this. The game is called The Last Door. It's on sale on GOG.com currently. It's 75% off. And even if you don't like spooky games like I do, and you should get the game because of the soundtrack. The soundtrack is made by Carlos Viola. I just had him here. You see it? You saw it? And it's just wonderful. All of the, I think there are 30 pieces of music, something like that, and all of them are loopable. So if you're like me and you have, you like to be a dungeon master for a pen and paper group, you just have to get this. It's very atmospheric, it's wonderfully done, and it's just amazing. So, yeah, even if you don't want to play a scary game, get the game for the soundtrack. It's well worth it. Anyway, I will try this now. Members and babies, I'm happy Piranjade also says GUG, not GOG. I try. I'm German, so I normally speak German, and then I say GOG and not GUG. Because GOG and Margaret and all the evil stuff. So, yeah. Okay. I'm stalling. I know I'm stalling. DZ asks, is it getting dark where you play? Yes. Yes, it is. And also, the lamp in the living room where I'm sitting on the PC blew out today, so I'm sitting here in medium darkness, and I'll play a spooky game. Yes! I'm still stalling. Okay, we can do this. Okay, I'm firing up the game. Loading. Loading. Oh yeah, I enabled closed captions because I thought that would be better. I'm not really happy with the resolution right here, so I will see if I can change it. Full screen disabled. That seems to be all I can do here. Okay, so we'll just do this. Music seems to be fine, I think. I can change it in OBS but later if we need some more music. Okay. So, there are several episodes we can play. I'll start with episode 1. If you're curious about the game, the episode 1 is, you can get it as a demo on the developer's website. And there are also some extra stuff here, and apparently there are achievements. And, this is the collector's edition, which comes with this wonderful, wonderful soundtrack. Okay, let's go in there. The letter. After all the things I have seen, okay. Oh, I can't see where this is going. This is a chair and this is a rope. And he just said something like, oh, after all the things I have seen. Oh, come on, game. We don't have to start like that. We can be friends. No. Yeah, I thought so. Rope. Oh, sorry, I was trying to fix the music a bit. Yeah. Rope. And chair. After all the things I have done. Oh. No. I cannot escape the course my life has taken. Now I'm beyond redemption. Yeah. I just hope you can forgive me someday. Jade Electro's Piranjade, you never had an office chair rodeo? I had an office chair rodeo and it did not look like this. Oh, this is not a good way to start a game. Oh. Yours sincerely, Anthony Beechworth. That name! Oh, I'm sorry. Ah! Strangulation, yeah, I can see that. Stronger. Okay, maybe I should not have chosen the closed captions. Yeah, Carlos Viola, I told him about him. Okay. I think this is just credits, intro. Chat, you have to give me some feedback about if the music is too loud, because for me it's just mighty too loud. This is blowing off my ears. Okay, this is better for me. I couldn't hear myself talk. That's not good. Okay, we have scary birds, apparently. That is not good. I used to have a boyfriend, and he played all the Resident Evil parts, and I do remember those damn birds. Like, crushing through that damn window. October 1891. Okay. Videte mi ne kiskiat. Okay. This is in English, right? This was all my childhood friend Anthony Beechworth had written in his letter. It had been many years since I had heard that sentence. It was the motto of the science and philosophy group that we had secretly run as students back when we were in that secluded boarding school in Scotland. We had left it all behind, like mere childhood memories. That letter was unusual. It could only mean something awful must have happened. Yes. But he wrote the letter before that. Something that must remain absolutely secret. I had to find out what was going on. Do I? Without delay, I took the first morning train to Sussex and made my way to the address on the letter. Peter, can you lower the music volume just a tad? I can. I always tab out when I do that, that's why the music is interrupted then for a moment. So there's the house. That looks like a scary house. Episode 1, The Letter. Okay, I have a lens. Okay. As the obvious option would be the door, I would go. What the hell is this? A murder of crows is eaten eagerly. There are so many birds that I cannot see their prey from here. Yeah, well, maybe we don't want to. Maybe, but I'm sure the game will want us to know. Those crows are too vicious. Getting close could be dangerous. Yep. Good thinking. What is this? The garbage bin. Judging from the foul odor, I would say it has not been emptied in a fortnight. Okay. We go back to the front door. This is strange. Everything is silent. As if there was no one living here. Oh my god, did they not clean up? Is the other guy still hanging? Oh, and scary wind. Is the other guy still hanging? Oh no! I'm worried about Anthony. I have to find him. No, you don't. No, you don't want to. Yeah, make yourself at home. Remove the coat. Good thing. A note on the table. Dear Mr. Beechworth, due to recent events, the situation has become unbearable for us, and much to our regret, we have no other choice but to leave. We will remain forever grateful for all these years in your service. God bless you, Mr. and Mrs. Brewer. Okay. The grandfather clock. It's the only sound around here. No, I also hear the scary wind. Don't lie to me. Okay, an opening here and there and... Oh, there's a picture. Is this Anthony? The years have not been kind to him. You have no idea. You have no idea. Okay. My coat. Yeah, take it and we leave. I think I should go upstairs and get this over with, I guess. Ooh. Unsettling music. Yeah, that worked. And it's dark. Oh my goodness. The door is stuck. It won't open. Okay, and go. Intriguing music. Yeah, that's better. Machine that plays recorded music. I did not know that Anthony was such an enthusiast for new inventions. Oh, okay. I think a recording of sound or music can be played if an engraved cylinder or disc is inserted, but I see no such object in this device. Oh, I'm pretty sure we'll find something later with a scary message or stuff. A cabinet with glasses and some liquor bottles. There is also a matchbox. Matchbox makes light. Get me a matchbox. This matches could come in useful. Yes, I think so too. I've got matches. That is good. A fireplace. It looks like it hasn't been cleaned in a long time. That doesn't matter. It can give light and it can give warmth. I'm completely fine with that. The large window is wide open, letting the cold dusk air in. Considering the birds out there, we should maybe close it. Can we close it? Come on over here. Come on over here. Okay. Can you not walk over here? You cannot. A deer head overlooks the room with glass eyes. Oh. Can I use the matches with it? There is no need to do that. Well, if you don't want light and warmth, then that's fine, I guess. A seascape. Mm-hmm. Rainy mountain. The portrait is crooked. Oh, I don't like that. Especially when I'm nervous. Well, that didn't make it better. Yeah, great. This guy is useless. Ah! Well, Anthony is dead, so he will not complain. An old rosary. A cord with beads with a solid wooden crucifix. I kind of hope I won't need this, but I'm pretty sure I will. Chat, I have no idea what this game is about, by the way. I'm really going in blind here. Am I wearing this? No, this is my tie, I guess. Okay. The painting depicts a deep, dark forest. Yeah. Small plant brings some life to this place. Might be the only life in here. Oh, there's another door. Let's take this one. Oh, it's closed, of course. I should try and find the key to open it. Well, if you want. lamp! Yes! No, 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 take the lamp, take the lamp, take the lamp! Matches, wood lamp. Oh, wonderful! Can I... Oh, okay. Yes! Oh, it's used up my matches? Oh no! Master Anthony has made us get rid of our religious object. What is going on with him? Luckily, I found a place to hide my rosary. I cannot pray every night without it. This is not good. Master Anthony has been complaining about Alfie. What would a simple cat do to him? Oh no, he was not... Oh no, 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 he didn't do any mean things to a cat, did he? Oh. He ordered us to keep him out of the house at all times. Still, I cannot let that poor thing starve. He is such a clever cat. Every time I open the window, he knows food is waiting for him. Anyway, I'm worried about Master Anthony. He's growing more and more unlike himself every day. Okay. Master Anthony is spending whole days locked inside his office. He wants us to leave him food at the door, but he barely eats anything. I'm really worried. An empty bowl, like the one used to feed pets. Okay, can we take anything here? The window is so dirty that I can barely see through to the outside. There's a discoloration on the wall in the shape of a cross, as if one had hung here for many years and been recently removed. Okay. Okay, I think that's all, but I got a lamp. Can I even save in this game or something like that? I'm not sure. What will happen if I go to main menu? Well, I will just resume. I will find out what the main menu does. I'm just pressing some keyboard buttons here to see if I can save or stuff. S for save? No. Okay. No saving. Is this this door I came through, so it's okay that it's open. Okay, 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 okay. Okay. Kitchen stuff. Cleaning cloth. We could build a Molotov cocktail maybe and just burn it all down. Plates and pans. Days old leftovers. He didn't clean up before he killed himself. Herbs and ingredients. Can we get some of those? No. Get through this door. That might be the back door, I guess. I've unlatched the door. That's ominous. It's the back door. Okay, can I use the rosary at the crows? No. I don't really know what they're eating. Okay, let's go back inside. Okay. I would say hello to Vlad, but he says he can't hear the stream, so that seems to be useless. Can somebody type in chat that I'm saying hello to him? Hello, Vlad! So now that I have light, maybe I can see something more upstairs. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Boarded up doorway. Picture missing. Some squares are invisible cleaner. It looks like some of the paintings are missing. I mean, this looks like lambs. I wish I still had my matches. Okay, two doors. Let's try this one. Locked from the inside. Okay, that might be the room. You know, the room. I don't know actually how people find out if something is locked from the inside or from the outside. Oh. The master bedroom, I presume. All the fireplaces are really dirty. a gentleman with a serious and inquisitive look. Oh, I'm not sure if I'm able hands for your streams, Vlad, but thank you. Small photographs and all daguerreotypes, mostly family portraits. Okay. I'm afraid if I click on the bed, he will want to sleep or stuff like that. This window leads to a balcony shared with the adjacent room, so I can maybe get over there. Oh, there's something. There's a nightstand or something. The silver key! Key means progress. Double bed from the accumulated dust. I would guess it has not been slept in over for a long time. Chat, you're not seeing it, but I'm sitting here with like my hand grabbing my shirt. Window locked. I cannot open the ledge. It is stuck. Perhaps I could do so using a small... Ah! EA just... Ebenezer just came from behind and hacked me!
Sorry, chat.
Okay. Okay. I guess a silver key is a small key. The key is too thick, something thin. My goodness! I feel my heart pounding. He's still standing behind me! Could you please stop that? No, you're not supporting me that way! My! Okay, doesn't fit on this door. The door is stuck, so maybe the key will not help there. Oh no, I did not try the rosary. No chance. Okay, I'll go back and try the rosary. I would love to see if this guy can run. That might be an important feature later. Thank you for the plug from my YouTube channel. I have just started uploading stuff there. I really make YouTube videos, or at least I haven't until now, so I might do that one day. But yeah. Did you see that he just more like ran out of the light room into the dark corridor, and now he's like making baby steps in here? I already dislike him for that. Okay, wait. Can we just leave? Can I just leave? Maybe he's refusing to leave because I don't have the code? Oh, the Weekendslice! Well, thank you! Thank you for handing over the spooky show for an evening, and thank you for recommending a game! Yeah, I'm trying to do you proud. Can I use the rosary to just tie this together? No. Can you move there? I want the window closed. There are the birds out there. I don't trust the damn birds. But you're not moving. Okay. No, I think the thing that was locked was the herb thing, which was in here. No, what? Something was locked. What was locked? Oh, one of the other doors down here was locked. So let's use the key on on there. I really, this scale with that Ebenezer did to me, I'm so... Well, wasn't that one closed? No, I was in here. That was dirty, that wasn't... This one. Okay. I found a key. Yeah. Okay. Is this a cellar? But I didn't go down any stairs, did I? This is a slate disc record. The sleeve reads The Carnival of Venice. Well, take it. Might be more happy music on there. There, what is this? Slightly rusted iron crowbar. Yes! Yes, that is a good thing. That is a good thing. A small pile of firewood, twigs and chunks of dry bark. I knew I would have to make a fire. Can I take it? No. Can I light it? No. The boiler looks like it's been out of use for a long time. Yeah, well, I... There were sounds. There were sounds there. I just heard sounds. I cannot see anything interesting enough inside to justify prying it open. Well, it's there. Okay, 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 okay. Oh, if any one of you is an indie developer and needs a guy to make music for your game, you can hire the guy who made the music for this game, Carlos Viola. He has a webpage, carlosviolastudio.com. So, yeah. Okay, I have a crowbar. I guess this could be the small thing to unlatch the window upstairs. Or maybe I could hit the crows outside with it. But then I would just be able to see what they're eating. So I don't think that would actually make anything better. Okay, a record. Yeah, not good. Not good at all. Okay, 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 okay. No, not getting better. It must be broken. I do not know what to make it stop. Oh, yeah, that's wonderful. No, that would destroy the gramophone, and it must be very expensive. I don't care. Make it stop. Make it stop. Okay, we just leave the room. Okay, we can... The music has abruptly stopped. Okay. I cannot do anything. Okay, now... Shit! Okay. Set them on fire. Show them the rosary. Here, 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 here. I don't think I should enter this room. I mean, this game might be over if I do now. They look at me. They just change direction. Yeah, look at that. I'm going. Are they still in there? Yes, they are still in there. This is not a good thing. I mean, this, if he was a reasonable person, he would now take his coat and leave. Okay, so this is just the average non-reasonable person in a computer game, yes? I'm sweating. One moment. I need to dry my hand here. I guess I could maybe open this with the crowbar, but right this, I don't know if I want to. I really don't know if I want to. Riska says, go outside, Piranjade. That is actually very smart. Riska is completely right. I shall go outside. I shall go outside and leave. Come on, go down. Still cannot leave. He doesn't know how to leave. There's still one crow there. A dying crow, not much life left in it. Well, yeah, great! Now we have a dead crow. No, it's making sounds. Oh, no, 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 no. Make it stop. Make it stop. Make it stop. Set it on fire. Oh, wonderful. Now I have a dying crow in my thing. Oh, nose, 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 nose. No, it's still making sounds. They're gone. The curtains are drawn. Yeah, open them. Yeah, I see that they're drawn. This fireplace is still not clean, so that means the crows did not come through there. I hate you, gramophone. I hate you. Oh, come on! What can I do? Can I stuff the... I don't know. What can I do? Can I... Herbs and ingredients. Now come on, let's... I don't know. Stuff it with herbs until it's healthy or stuff? Mm-hmm. Memories and 8-bit change the host command. If you like her getting scared, let us know. We make her play more scary games. No! No! Grubix, our game sounds not too quiet. I can turn them up for you a little bit. One moment. There, you now have more game sounds. Okay. Irobing, I had already looked stuff at... Oh, I will just ignore that dying crow now. At the stuff at the table. It's, little crow. It's food. Yes, I hear the dying crow. Okay. Crowbar this. Come on. Yeah, window locked. We know. I mean, this is not a small this is a crowbar. Not breaking it. The crow has a peak. Maybe I can open it with the peak of the crow? No, cannot. Okay. It's not getting... The sound it's making is not getting better. If you want me to make the game sounds louder, chat, you will have to tell me. And tell me by tagging me, because I'm just... is pounding so loud. My god, what happened here? Leave me alone. There's somebody lying on the bed there. Shit. Oh shit. The lifeless body of a woman. It has been here for a few days. Looks like she's clutching a note in her hand. Well, leave it. Leave it for her. It's her note. I have to take it, right? I have to click on the dead body thing. It's a letter. Yeah, let's take this one. Dear Margaret, it has been days since Anthony left his office. I can hear him whisper, angrily, frightfully, and it gets worse at night. Our service left a few days ago. Without their help and company, I am lost. I can barely walk out of bed, and not even the doctor will come here after his argument with Anthony. My husband has developed a horrible ability to break anyone's will. I do not know what to do. I do not have any strength left. I wish I could send you this letter. Your dear friend, Anna Beechworth. Why did she take his last name by marrying him? Or maybe it's, I don't know. She might have had a better name. Diane Crow, could you please stop? An old wheelchair? A letter in feeble handwriting. I cannot go on. All is lost. It is a diary page. I cannot stand their stares. They watch me. They judge me. They despise me. I know they think I am not worthy of this family. But who are there but dust and bones? A memory. Leave me. I do not need you. Leave me alone. Did it just get darker in here? I think it just got darker in here. Nothing of interest on this dressing table. Okay. I will now try to take that letter, and I'm pretty sure I will regret it. I'm writing what will surely be my final thoughts, my last lines, my last breath. I do not know what kind of dark power has turned my husband into what he is now. A stranger with a look bereft of all sanity, compassion, and human warmth. I do not know what shadow has slowly darkened our lives. I do not know this foreign guest that now dwells in our souls. This is kind of Lovecraft. You will be surprised to hear I read some Lovecraft. I once had the theory that if I just... Oh, it goes on. I do not know where it is from, but I'm sure it is not from this world. This is so Lovecraft. I will meet my brothers and sisters soon. I will be free from this abyss of madness and fear. Soon I will stop trembling. Keep! Okay. A simple long hairpin. Take it? Okay, now we have a small thing. I once had the theory that if I just confronted myself with enough horror movies and books and stuff, that I would get better at not being scared by them. It didn't work out. Yeah, this is pretty. Okay. Window tapping. Okay. Oh my goodness, there's a child in this house somewhere? No. No, 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 no. Oh. Okay. Portrait of Anthony standing beside a mounted wildcat or lynx. Paint looks fresher around the animal's head. That would just smear the fresh paint. Okay. There's a big raven perched outside the window, tapping on the glass with its beak. Can I scare it off by showing it the dying crow? Look there! I kill you! Why was it? I'm already afraid to just move out of a room here because it can just all get worse. Okay, this time it didn't. There's nothing more in here, right? Okay, dying crow, could you just die, please? Oh. Okay. Okay, I will drink something, and then we go on. Then we go on. Okay. Okay, we go on. We go on. Okay. Study or something like that. Press cutting, spin the wall, the illustrated London News, 1887. 1887? Judge kills himself under strange circumstances. 1888, Earl found dead floating in the Thames. 1889, famous actor found bled to death in his hotel room. A map of the region of Sussex, with markings drawn on its surface. Cat? Is it dead? No, it's a lynx. A lynx mounted and stuffed. This is a fine work of taxidermy. It's alive. Let's guess it's alive. Come on, kitty. See the crow? Some torn out diary pages. They will not bother me anymore. I am done with their censorious gazes, their whispers. It is already. There's only one thing left to do. There's a hammer or something. A common hammer in good condition. That's a strange description. Remains of chemical experiments. Some sort of spilled chemical product. It smells strongly of vinegar. Can you put the cloth in there? And so we can then maybe alter the painting. No, there's a door. I didn't want to go to a door. Strange book, written in language unknown to me. Oh, this game is originally in Spanish, I believe. I was thinking about maybe doing playing it in Spanish, but I don't think I can play it ever again. So, yeah, sorry. I could go up there and find my dead friend, but somehow I'm not in the mood. So this might be the door leading back to the corridor, right? Right, okay. So I have to go up there and find my dead friend. The golden force trapdoor is locked. I need to find the key. I would really like to dip the old cloth in the spilled chemicals, but it's not... Okay. Can I dip the crow in the chemicals? No. Can I just... I have to admit I meant to do that, but I'm still not happy. And now everything is quiet. Everything is quiet is not good, right? Okay, music starts again. Can I now put the cloth in there? No. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, okay, okay. We have already read that. A can of paint thinner! Okay. 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 I'm so afraid of everything right now. This is just not good. I'm pretty sure some more horrible things will happen here. Can somebody change back the host command, please? I'm pretty sure I will suddenly age if I play more scary games. The thing's mouth is open as if it were growling. So I guess I have to go back, and maybe something is in the mouth of the lynx. Okay. Open it. Now can you just open it? Oh, come on. This is not... Yeah, before the reveal. I mean, this is just... Don't be stupid, guy. Open the damn mouth of the damn thing. I mean, come on. Looking at the ass? No. Okay. He's not that smart though. I think this is what I have to do. I have to open the mouth of the thing. Why is he not doing it? I mean, he could just use his hands and pry it open if he doesn't want to use the hammer. Happy plays with kittens and JRPGs. I'm fine with that. By the way, chat, now that I'm just walking through this totally not horrible dark corridor, would any of you like to know what the other options would have been in the straw poll I made, or you're not interested? You know, this one is still closed, but it's only stuck. Maybe I can unstuck it with a hammer. No. This is... I don't want to go over there again. Can we just open the damn curtains or burn them down or something? Just destroy something. I would like to destroy something now. Okay. What could I just go and destroy? Can I destroy something in the... Dion has options of what? Before the stream, this is not my normal slot of streaming. I stream during the week normally. Plate and pants, they will not resist the hammer. I made a straw poll and there were three options of what I could stream today. Regular, surprisingly different, and does this even count as a game? And the people voted for surprisingly different, which made me play point and click adventure, which is something I normally don't stream, and a scary game, which is also something I normally don't stream, so it's double surprisingly different. And like something spilled out of there. So yeah, so people voted for something surprisingly different and got this, so but I want to see if they want to be spoiled, kind of, and know what would have been in the other options. So, I don't know. I don't like the sounds down here. But I'll put the crow in the thing. Leaving it in the boiler will achieve nothing. He reacted to that. That is more scary than I would have liked. I fear I should go back to the bedroom. Because the bedroom would be... If I would write something scary, I would now have a scary thing in the bedroom. Not that this is not scary, because this is scary, but still. It was in here that was this room, yeah. I think there's... Can I... I don't know. Crow and bowl? I can put the crow in the bowl. I have laid the crow in the bowl. Yeah, okay, you did that, but why? Can you now burn it? You will now smash it with a hammer because you're just a creep. True? You will now smash... No, you don't. I don't even know, don't want to know why you did that. I will never, oh no, I don't want to come back in this room ever again. Okay, the other games. Regular would have been a really old RPG. I have not completely decided what one it would have been. Maybe Might and Magic 4, I was considering that. And is this even a game? I would have liked to show you how to set up a game of Creatures Exodus properly. So, how to get the docking station working now that the servers are offline, what kind of fan add-ons to use and stuff like that. Okay, nothing scary in here, so maybe they're just not like me. As apparently this guy is stupid and just doesn't get it, does anybody have an idea what I have overlooked? Or what I should do next? Ah, that goddamned cat, he meows every night and it is for me, I know. He's mocking me, he knows my secret, he knows. I will not let him ruin everything. I do not have any choice. I have yet to put an end to his miserable life. Or better yet, I will blind him. Oh my goodness! I wish it was... Ebenezer! Can you switch on the light in the other room? Now? No, not like really now. Thank you. Like I said, it's dark in this room because the light is not working properly. No, now it's dark behind me still. Thank you. You Gabby Gabby Lynx, you would not confess, no, not you. Okay, he still doesn't get a clue. GMC Google's Creature Exodus. Just look it up on GOG. It's it's sold there, so you can see it there. I played it back then when it came out. I had already played Creatures 1 and Creatures 2. And so of course I got to play Creatures Exodus, which was Creatures 3 back then. Creatures Exodus is the compilation of all the things that came out for Creatures Exodus. I guess the blind cat will now be in the servant's room eating the dead crow. And no, it's not. But yeah, I could maybe put the rosary back there. No, I cannot. Come on. Maybe I just have to get closer. Closer. Okay. No, it doesn't do anything. I think I have to open the window to let the cat in. Okay, now I go outside. Oh. It just fell down again. It looked like the window frame is rotten. I would need some kind of cord to hold the window open. Well, I have some kind of cord, so open it. And use the rosary. Okay, can now the cat come in? The horror. Oh, what is this? There's a tiny dark hole in the wall. Was that there before? No? I will now go outside, come in, and hope for the cat. No cat yet. Can I don't know. The cat is supposed to come as soon as I open the window. There. Every time I open the window, he knows food is waiting for him. Kitty, 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 cat. Kitty cat. I'm not even sure why I want the cat to come. I hear something in the distance. It sounds like a lament. Come again? There it is again. Is it in here? Oh my goodness! Oh. Okay, I still have 1 hour to go and I really don't know how. I have such goosebumps. Oh my! The blind cat took the crow, went into the hole, and now fell down into the boiler? Is that what happened? Oh, fuck it. Yeah. Oh, no, no, no. Shit, 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 shit. Shit, shit, shit. Oh, fuck this. Fuck this. It's in there, right? There will be a jump scare now or something like that. Cat is in there. Cat is in the damn boiler, right? Oh, this is so not good. Oh, I hate this game. G-Putting says, kick the boiler, that will wake up, will wake the cat up. The cat is awake, I can hear it. There. The cat seems to be behind this wall. Okay, get the cat out. The black cat is staring at me, but wait, its eyes are missing. Yeah? Yeah? Good lord, it almost ripped my eyes out. It has run away into the dark. There's an open chest with a dark cloak, a mask, and a knife. Okay. The knife could be useful. Yeah, better we have it than anybody else. There's nothing more useful than it. There's a dark cloak in there. If we want to hide in this game, a dark cloak could be very, 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 very useful. But the cat could still be somewhere here. So can I now, I don't know, use the, okay, I cannot use the knife on that. Okay, so now I have like a murder of crows out of there and a blind killer cat in here. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. I'm so tense. I'm really like expecting bad things here. My left hand is grabbing my desk. I guess I can now use the knife to pry open the dead cat Link's thing. I managed to get the Link's mouth open. There's a golden key inside. Surprise, who would have thought? Okay. You know what my problem is with horror games, also with horror movies and horror books? Sometimes progression just doesn't make things better. In any way. At least for me. Oh god, no! Anthony, no! Yeah, I was less surprised than you are. Okay, okay. Lifeless body of my dear friend. What madness could have led him to commit such an act? You know, from everything here in the house, like, walls with messages written in blood and cats that apparently your good friend Anthony pried their eyes out and all this kind of stuff. This is the most shocking. You already find a dead woman down there, you know, and she apparently died a horrible death. So, yeah. No, I don't want to put him down there. Not yet. What is anything else here I can do? What is this? Portrait of a woman, and a nice bed. She looks very happy here. Yeah. Good. It is a sealed letter. Dear J. David, if you're reading these lines, then I'm nothing but a dead body hanging before you. I write to you in my last shreds of lucidity. You are one of my oldest friends, and when I sent you the letter asking you to come here, I did not doubt for a moment that you would. Had you failed me this evening, everything would have been lost. I have found myself involved in a series of horrible incidents. Yeah, I can tell. For reasons beyond my comprehension and sanity, I have become a total stranger to myself and to my closest relatives, capable of the most indescribable and atrocious acts. I cannot give you any more details at this time. I must ask you to go immediately back to the boarding school where we made that pact, where we all swore our honor, that sentence that would protect us. Window tapping. I can see it says window tapping up there. We must go. So I must now go back to the boarding school. I'm happy to leave this house if the damn crows let me. This letter must not reach anyone else, so it is imperative that you destroy it immediately. The lives of the rest of the group, and yours too, are in great danger. Do not delay. They are already waiting for you.
No.
Seeing is believing, David. Do not forget that. Always your loyal friend, Anthony Beechworth. I don't want to click because I'm pretty sure something horrible is now... Ah! I knew it! Okay. Okay. One moment. Okay, I'll go on in a moment. Oh, by the way, the developers made all of the assets of the game available for free, so you can download them and use all of the horror stuff they have in here for your own wonderful adventure that you want to build. I need to continue, Chad, right? I need now to continue. True. Okay. Episode 2, memories. Maybe they have some happy memories. Wouldn't that be a thing? Happy memories? How about that? Previously on The Last Door, yeah. Come on, do a recap. Jeremy David receives a mysterious letter from his childhood friend Anthony Beechworth. He travels to find his friend's manor in Sussex, where he learns of Anthony's descent into madness and the death of his wife Anna Beechworth. David faces the perils of the house and finally finds the dead body of his friend who committed suicide. Anthony's final letter warns David of an unknown danger and asks him to remember his past by going back to the boarding school they both attended years back. That is like a very cleaned up version of what happened. Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Oh, this does not look sane. Oh, I am this guy. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Okay, and the only thing... Okay, take this and... Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Oh, come on, I will... Oh, does every episode start like that? Give us each day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Okay. Now tell me, where are you? What do you see? EA is eating in the background. Those are the other sounds you hear. That is not my breathing you hear there. Yeah, good things, good things. I'm thinking of good things. There'll be crows, I know it. What is she doing? Get close to her. Get close to Anna. Jeeps. Count to three, you'll wake up. One, two. Yeah, three. Now wake up, wake up. You can rest now, Mr. Devitt. That will be enough for today. Are these sessions really necessary? I'm confident that now this is the best course of treatment for your symptoms. Now, did you ever see him again? I saw it. What did you see? Can you describe it? It looked like an eye, I would say. It was like an eye, perfectly rounded and dark, deep and empty. Accompanied by the most horrific, painful screams I've ever heard, inside a complete darkness, where an evil dwells deep below, a forgotten fear for human reasoning, but undoubtedly still rests deep down inside our being. In my case, that fear has already awoken. What is Chad doing there? Memories in 8-bit. Yes, Piranjade needs to play Never-Ending Nightmares. No, I don't! Piranjade, would you play the cat lady on stream? No, I won't! What is up with you guys? Those are horror games! They are scary, I've heard of them. I can understand why you're disturbed, Mr. Devitt. With your permission. I would like to consult on your case with a colleague of mine, a man I've known for many years, and who's more versed in modern psychological practices. I think his knowledge and experience would be very helpful in enabling us to understand your condition. If you think it would help, Doctor, I'll leave it in your hands. The agony grows increasingly unbearable, and if you believe this man can help, then I welcome his aid. Thank you, Dr. Wakefield. I bid you good evening. Oh, for a moment I thought it would be more happy and now it's a cemetery. Anthony, my friend, what really happened to you? How could you have let your wife Anna die so awfully? Yeah, that's a good question there. These doubts consume my soul. I hardly remember the time we spent together as schoolmates. So did this guy, Mr. Devitt, not go back to the boarding school. Okay. Grivix, I guess no Five Nights at Freddy's Piranjade. No, Grivix. Piranjade, would you play Adventures of Shaggy on stream? I could consider that. I confess that beyond our enduring friendship, I can recall little of those years. Were your words a result of an increasing loss of sanity? Well, maybe. In your letter, you wrote that someone awaits me. A warning to warn me from a genuine danger or merely the ravings of a brilliant mind addled by insanity? Something stirs uneasily within my heart. I will not rest easily again until I go back to the boarding school and find out what secrets may lie within. That's a good plan. If it's a happy, bright place with happy, bright children. Jedi Lecto says, I would be so inclined to not subject to Piranjade to horrible things. Thank you, Jedi Lecto. Farewell, Mr. and Mrs. Beechworth. Rest now in peace. Dark is not good. More dark. Yeah, something is coming again. I have to sit in a different way or I'll fall off this chair while doing this stream. This is not good. Hanna Play says, I'd love to see Piran play the Fear series. At least she has a slow motion and a huge arsenal of weapons. Ebenezer played Fear, so I know Fear. But as I'm not good in FPS, and the AI is surprisingly good in that game, and I already know it, so no, I think I'm out. Ha! Okay, let's go on here. Episode 2, Memories. I fear the school will not be a happy and bright place, right? There's a postcard inside the mailbox. Let's steal somebody's postcard. Dear Matthew, it has been several months. I still have heard no news from you. My brothers insisted you have abandoned me, but I'm sure you remain true. I know that you would never do that to me, for I know your heart and the honesty in your eyes. I got this address from a hospital in London and pray that it reaches you safely. If that is the case, I want you to know that I will always be waiting for you. Forever yours, Juliet Holloway. Am I Matthew? I'm not, right? Okay, places for crows to sit. The Angel Gabriel. The school's emblem. I remember it being very pristine, but it looks neglected and dirty now. Stones. We can throw with stones. A stone legal lies on the floor. It appears to have broken off the fountain. Take it. We can throw stones at other people. Okay. No, this is still that. Look, somebody's in here and she's alive. Well, hello, your most wonderful nun. Pardon, excuse me, sister. Oh, I red writing. This might be an evil nun. Good evening, sister.
Good evening. I'm Mother Elizabeth. What brings you here, mister?
David, I'm a former student of this boarding school.
As you can see, Mr. Devitt, this stopped being an academic institution a long time ago, and is now exclusively dedicated to prayer and the well-being of the patients our under care.
Oh no!
I'm in an asylum.
Oh no! You know, I sometimes watch some streams that Vlad do, and I watched something that Memories in 8-Bit also did with that reporter, with that thing with the camera and that asylum thing. And that was not so funny as it could have been. I see. Even so, may I please speak to Mr. Devitt? I'm afraid that we're too busy to start wasting time talking about past issues. In addition, there's little to say. We sisters arrived after the boarding school had closed down everybody but Monsignor, of course.
Monsignor? Exactly. But you didn't answer my question. Why have you come to this place, Mr. David? It'd be good for me to appreciate the passage of time. This place will help me remember if I... Okay. Well, this does not sound really sane. This just sounds strange, and this is not good. It'd be good for me to appreciate the passage of time. I will try the first one. This sounds strange, but at least not insane. I guess it would be good idea to visit this place again and perceive the passage of time. Perceive the passage of time? What are you talking about? So maybe it wasn't that a good idea. Okay. This place will help me remember my past. If you have memory problems, I would recommend you to visit a doctor immediately and don't waste your time here. To be honest, To be honest, I prefer not to talk about it. I couldn't tell you why this place is so important for me, but it's a lot. Well, I appreciate your honesty, Mr. David. I'll allow you to stay around here. I hope I won't regret my decision. This is kind of strange. Normally, in point-and-click adventures and in RPGs, you have to give it a little bit of information to go on. But right now, here, this would be the right decision. Here would have been to not tell her. Okay. Don't worry, Mother. Thank you. Oh, I took my coat off. That's how it started the last time. Okay. Boah. Among the baggages I can see a packet of letters. Bound by twine. Well, let's steal somebody's letters. Beep. I'd ask you not to touch my belongings, please. You're not aware who you're talking to. I'm sorry? So, who am I talking to? I'm talking to the guy in the bed now. Pay him no mind. He has been delirious for some days. I'm Mrs. Mary Winch, and this is my brother, Matthew. Oh! Matthew!
Juliet! Why have you left me? Why don't you answer my letters? Cuff my letters!
You see, the poor man is still obsessed with the fiancée. He won't accept that she left a month ago. My poor Matthew. I'm very sorry, Mrs. Winch. I hope he recovers. Thank you. I'd give him the postcard. Mr. Winch, I think this letter's addressed to you. Oh, thank you. Leave it with me, if you'd be so kind. As you can see, my brother is too weak to read it. Well, Matthew, let's see who has written to you. Oh, it's a letter from our mother.
Oh, you damn liar! Oh!
Dear Matthew, I hope you're recovering. I wish that. Your beloved sister and you would come back home soon. Okay. You're a damn liar. Mrs. Winch is making up the letter's content. Yeah, I can see that. But maybe I can now steal the other letters while she's... Ha! I think I should try to lure her away and then give the letters to him, because I guess these will be letters from his fiancée as well, and I would like to make him happy again. A magazine entitled Weird Tales, that is cool. Hee hee. Are you alright, madam? There was a rhythmic sound like breathing. What do you mean? It was last night. I felt an increasing pressure on my temples. Something dry and rough like tree bark rushed against my leg. And I saw something on the wall like a growing shadow. I lit the lamp and there was nothing. I'm sure it was just a nightmare, madam.
Yep, let's hope so.
Okay. Another nun? Oh, please help is not good.
Please, someone, pity.
I'm sorry, you cannot be here. Is there some way I can help? Don't worry about it, sir. The Lord looks after each and every one of our patients. He will provide you with all the help you need. And if you wish, you can pray here, next to the statue of Our Lady. Do you think she is beautiful? The Virgin listens to those in need. Yeah, those are many crucifixes. Okay. The gloomy statue of the Virgin Mary makes this place even more mournful, if that is possible. Ha! Can we steal this? It has light. This picture of the Virgin Mary gazing at you is supposedly to portray sympathy and compassion for you. However, she seems to look more pained and sorrowful here. So many doors, so many people. Oh, this looks like a classroom. I remember that we used to keep here some textbooks. Now there's a music box. Yeah, we like music boxes. Oh, I took the music box. Oh well, now I have a music box. Why not? I will not put it on again. The gramophone was horrible enough. Okay, it's red and it's only a carpet. We're making progress here. 1876. Father Ernest seems unusually troubled today. Several times he paused abruptly in the middle of a lecture for no reason, even during his favorite class, theology. Today, Father Ernest was very irritable. Collins made a comment and was expelled from class for it, and even David was admonished for just for reading a philosophy book. I hope Father Ernest doesn't turn his ire toward me. My father will be disappointed if I fail to get good marks. It was very disconcerting to see Father Ernest entering class so pale and sweaty. In the middle of his lecture, he stumbled, dazed, and had to sit. Father Eugene taught our theology class today, and even though he doesn't know the subject matter as well as Father Ernest. When we asked him what had happened to Father Ernest, Father Eugene told us that he had taken ill. What worries me is that now Father Eugene is also starting to look unwell. Well, great. It's a curse, and it spreads. It has been a month since we last saw Father Ernest. We're told that he is still sick, but if he is so ill, then why hasn't a physician come to treat him? My studies are flagging, but I've taken it upon myself to read on my own. I hope this helps as I must succeed in spite of the problems happening around us. It was announced this morning that the school is to close. None of us know why, and we cannot get a straight answer from the faculty. They each dodge the question, and I'm starting to think they may not know the answer themselves. Their anxiety, or something like that, is palpable. The mysterious music. Oh, spectral moan. Oh, no. So they try to hide it behind a calm face. But what about Father Ernest? I hear he alone is to remain after we vacate the premises. There's a picture in the diary. Okay. It is the photograph of my graduating class. I see myself, Father Ernest, and Anthony. I do not remember the names of the others. One face has been completely scratched out. There's an odd sentence written on the board. In death there is hope. In death there is life. One must seek its true nature to understand the nothing. It looked like it has been there for some years, as the chalk has faded in some places. The nuns are in on it. There's something lying there, right? What is this? Dear brother, I've received your letter and I'll try to write you more frequently. I hope you're studying a lot and you feel comfortable here. We miss you a lot. When are you coming back? Father is in bed with fever and I do not feel very well, but I'm on medication. Today is my birthday and I'm feeling blue. It is a quiet and boring Sunday at the village. Mom is going to cook a lemon cake like those Grandma used to make. I wish we could eat it together. Write back soon. I'm looking forward to knowing how you're doing and what are you learning. How is Scotland and so on? A big hug, I think, a lot about you a lot, your dear sister. Okay. Oh, there's a coffin. Now we're being more direct here, game. Spade digging. Well, hello, Mr. Gravedigger. Good evening. I hope you're right and this turns out to be indeed a good evening.
My name is Devitt. I didn't know there was a graveyard here.
My pleasure, Mr. Devitt. I am Frank Baldwin. Do not ask me why, but Monseigneur specifically ordered to bury the corpses here.
Okay. Okay. Why?
What is there to understand, Mr. Devitt? God has forsaken this place.
Okay. Good to know. Thank you.
Excuse the interruption, Mr. Baldwin. I'll leave you with your work.
Have a nice evening.
Cool. Okay. A locked wood coffin badly finished. It seems that whoever made it was a bit rushed to finish. Okay. What is this? Oh, the coast! Piece of old fishing net. Why not? Nice! This looks cool. Many years drift have perfectly smoothed the flotsam into a small lock. Let's have a small look. Oh, this looks nice. I like this. The Lost Pilgrim, a seastack older students at the school used to climb. Somewhere up there are my initials. Okay. Okay, then I'm at the front again. No crows so far. That is good. Okay, I walked the left. Let's walk the right. Mr. David, these rooms are private, okay? Go upstairs. I guess the father's up here. Virgin Mary everywhere. Jesus. Well, this is not how it's supposed to be. Oh, they hung it over a door, right? Okay, let's try this. Oh, bathroom. Window, local mirror, there's a protruding piece. We get a lot of stuff here right now. There's something in the water there. There's a puddle in the shower hole with something shining under the grating. I cannot see it properly. So let's... I mean, we have a lot of different things. So we can see if we can use anything on here. No, he's not doing anything. The tap of the shower, yes? If I open the tap, the shiny object could be carried away by the stream of water. There's a puddle in the shower hole with something small under grating. Okay, this does not help. Okay. Can I not do this? Okay. Why can I not use the lock on it? Okay, so it must be something else, something I don't have yet. What is this? Just a couple of old towels. I cannot take them. I think it would also be unhygienic. Okay. Okay. I guess something horrible is behind this door. Let's face it. I'm feeling much better since the light is on here now, in my room. Only a nun might be less horrible than we thought. A syringe next to a flask with a label that reads morphine. Can we have that? On the upper shelf of the antique cupboard, a well-worn Bible and rosary beds gather dusk. Heimdall Plays, I'm ignoring that. Good evening, sister. Sister? All the suffering, all the tears, all our prayer our prayers unanswered. Oh, maybe she chose the wrong job. What do you mean, sister? All these years entrusted to the Lord, praying, looking for a sign, for something that can give me strength. Every day I hear them cry, pray, scream, and die. What for? Where are you, Lord? Why don't you answer me? Okay. Okay, I'll try this one. Maybe there is no Lord, sister. What should we do then? What is our purpose for living? I can't go on not like this. Excuse me, sir. Let's try the other one. No, okay. So it would have ended with that one anyway. She'll kill herself, right? She'll jump out of this window or stuff like that. Or use this. Maybe I can clap her over the head? Oh, we are back to mysterious music now. Great. Okay, not yet. Not yet. Oh well. I guess I have to go outside and see her fall or stuff like that. Because this game is evil. Okay, I've got lots of stuff. Can I, confront her? Yes. My letters, all the letters I wrote to dear Juliet, you never posted them. But why, Mary? Why could you do such a thing? How could you be so cruel? I had to do it, Matthew. We refuse to see how inappropriate a match she is for you. Her only interest is in marrying someone of your status, of our family status. It was for your sake I did this. I did it to protect you from that woman's treachery. No. You only thought about yourself, of your vanity. I can't bear to look upon you anymore, Mary. Leave me be. From this day forth, you are no sister of mine.
You dare banish me? I, who have stayed by your side all through your illness. Very well, Matthew. You will have your way. I will leave you, and then you will see how very alone you are. Farewell, brother.
Thanks be to the Lord that you have come to reveal my sister's cruelty, sir. Please, take this coin as a token of my appreciation. It was my lucky coin, though I hope it serves you better than it has myself.
Okay, I have a lucky coin now. Nothing I could do. I mean, can I talk to him again and maybe send a letter for him or something?
It seems that there is still hope to bring my fiancé back.
Okay. Then do that. Oh, what's this? Medical reports. Okay. Okay, she's sleeping now. Also sleeping. So, did I already use both those doors here? Yep, I did. Maybe I can give the lucky coin to this guy. No. Hmm. So, I've got a stone, I've got a music box. Maybe it will cheer him up. Music box? Music box? No. Mirror doesn't seem to be good anyway. I could club the nun. No. Okay, I accidentally used the mirror with the wood. Why? Let's see, use the stone with the lock? I could damage the wooden stick. Strange. Stone, mirror? No. Coin, mirror, anything? Okay. Interesting! Stuff! So... I can go back to the front, I came back to the beach. Okay. The music is awesome. I love the music in this game. No, I was in there already. I could show the coin to the nun. I think she will object. No. Okay. Okay, let's find out how this nun fares. Let's give her a lucky coin. So I guess I should now try to find out how to get that thing out of there. Maybe I can somehow... Okay, if I could take the towels, maybe I could use them to soak up the water and dry things out, then maybe? I don't know. Come on, put it back. Net in there. I really don't know what to do there. Chat, if you have any idea how to go on, tag me and tell me. Okay, there's a rusty old pipe. Let's knock on it. I mean, if I could open the pipe, then put the net in there, then turn this on so that it gets flushed into the pipe and into the net. That seems to be like a plan. So, can I somehow open the pipe? Doesn't look like it. Maybe not this. Maybe I have to do it somewhere else. Kane Philosopher says, I know what you do. What you need to do is use the coin on the music box in the room with the nun. Okay. That's an interesting idea, let's see. I made her happy! I did a good thing! Yay!
And she's off. So now I can steal her morphine. No, come on, steal it. She's gone. Oh, what do we have here? They are blocking the water stream. Okay, now the water flows freely. Can I now put the net in there? I could cut myself with the edge of the pipe. Okay, then maybe blunt it with a stone? Okay, that worked. Now put the net in there. Yes! Okay, we can get it, we can get it! Okay. Dark Deck writes, all the game review sites are corrupt as hell in my opinion. They get free games and stuff for nice reviews. Best is to read community reviews. I don't look at game reviewers. Okay. I'm not sure, chat. Do you, what we do here, streaming games for you, do you see that as a game review in some way? Okay, we have the shiny object. So what is it? It's a teardrop? It's a glass tier. Probably once belonged to a piece of jewelry. Interesting. So, maybe we can pin that on the Virgin Mary thing? Or maybe give it to this lady here? No. Night will save. No, it's a let's play what I'm doing here. Yeah, I've placed the glass in a hollow on the Virgin's cheek. It seems to that it fits perfectly. In the eyes of a fervent devotee, it could look like a real tear. If only I could make it shine. Ha! Yay! Oh! Oh! What the hell? Okay, you must help me. Okay, okay. Tell them about my pain. I describe the unbearableness pain, yet they do not listen. They pass me by without even looking at me. They say that they are praying for me, but it does not cure my ailment. I know, but I beseech you. You must be saving me from horrible torture. I will be eternally indebted to you. He wants something against his pain. I don't think I'm qualified to do that. But I should. Okay. He does want the morphine. He wants me to kill him. I don't want to kill him. Can I just give him less morphine? Can I just give him less morphine? Can just a little morphine?
she's praying. Let's steal the morphine. Can I talk to her? Maybe I can just give him a little morphine. Surprise sound. Yeah, you can say that. There's a note on the bed. Yeah, take it. What the fuck? What the... Where did he go? Is he here? This red carpet makes me so nervous. Did he go outside? Noise is coming from inside the coffin. Yeah! No. Somebody in the grave? Yeah, what in heaven? Okay. I cannot open the coffin with my own hands. The lid is nailed. Okay, I have a lock. Lock is too soft. The coin is too thick. Morphine? Music box? Help! What the hell? Oh, come on! A nun's habit and walking stick. These not all belong to the nun I spoke to by the window. Where did she go? Well, what do you think where she went? She's up there. She has decided to be young and climb the lost pilgrim again. Oh, but is there there's a walking stick in here? We can use that maybe? I mean, it's not nice to see an old nun's walking stick, I can get that, but still. Can I take one of the crosses, maybe, to lever it open? No. Apparently not. Maybe I can tell somebody, so somebody will come and help? Well, none of those, but there's a nun in the front room. Here, somebody's in the coffin, come on and help. Mr. Baldwin. Who's Mr. Baldwin? Monsignor instructed me to take him on as a caretaker. Many of the sisters find him a bit strange, but he performs his work well and complains little. Somebody's in the coffin outside. Okay. Somebody's in the coffin outside. Okay, so Mr. Baldwin was the gravedigger. Okay. Somebody's in the coffin outside, and I would have loved to tell you, but I'm not allowed, right? So, what to do? Somebody's in the coffin outside. Go and help. Oh! This guy is useless again! Okay, can I open this? Maybe with the log? Oh, with the morphine thing? With the coin.
No. Where did my knife go? Oh, I used the knife on the links and that was it. But there's nothing more here, right? Now it's only a puddle of water. Okay, 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 okay. Also wrote, I tried to give the morphine to the cough and it didn't work. Okay. Okay, chat. I did it. I did my 2 hours. I'm so good. Ooh, what the hell? There is the Mr. He has a thing. I like it. It looks like his toolbox. Okay, I'm gonna continue for a moment. I wonder if there's something useful in it. If I keep him distracted. I could give him the morphine. He will be very distracted then. Okay, blah. Okay, okay, okay. Ha! Got it. Chat, you want me to go there and have a look at the coffin? Well, he lies. So let's go back and have a look at the coffin. No, no, I'm not. I'm trying to go here. You want to know what's in the coffin, right? Right? Okay, okay. I don't. But I will do this for you too. No, it's getting black. Black is not good. Black is not... What the fuck is that? Ew, fuck. Okay. Whoa. Okay, 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 okay. Chat, this means Mother Elizabeth, the one who was sitting in the front, is now here. So, buy this game and find out yourself how it's going on. Okay. I'm done. I'm done, chat. I'm done for tonight. Woo! My goodness, I'm just not made for these games. I'm... okay. I did it. Whew. Okay, chat. I hope this was somehow enjoyable for you. And, I should be on again... Well, I will be on again on next week on Friday, the 26th, with Kerbal Space Program at 8 p.m. CEST. Which is 6 p.m. GMT. And, I will try to play at least the tutorials for Kerbal Space Program because I have not touched it yet. Although I want it. I want it from the man himself. So, tomorrow there's an empty slot after Jordi, actually, at 10 p.m. CEST. And I'm considering streaming there then, but I actually don't know what yet. So, chat, give me some feedback via Twitter, maybe, or post it in the schedule thread. ! Will you get that? So if something that I know, or something that's easy to prepare, or something like that, I will not. I'm not promising anything. I'm not promising that I'm streaming to you, for you again tomorrow night, but I'm at least considering it. So, okay. I will now not sleep. So I will see what I will now do. I will do some happy things. Not sure what yet. I will just do some very, very, very happy things now. The last door is 27% off right now. You should get it if you like scary games. And if you don't like scary games, get it for the amazing, amazing, amazing soundtrack. And G-Linux said, I don't think you were scared prior to it. Oh, I was so damn scared, especially in the first episode. You have no clue, G-Linux, I was so scared. Anyway, chat, I'll play some music for you now. And, Oh my god, I'm so... Yeah. Okay. I love you all, Chad. Thank you for being there for me. And I see you again tomorrow on Friday. Have a wonderful weekend. Good night. Bye.